Hello and welcome to Skink Paradise. It's a lazy summer day. Again, the large, darkly colored female, southeastern five-line skink, guards the log in the far reaches of the backyard. Just a few weeks earlier, a couple of her progeny were spotted here as well. They have long since moved on to find new territories of their own. Like their cousins, the Anolis, the skinks also have a second wave of hatchlings who emerge in the early fall. Of course, the Anolis are still very active as well. Here, one of the females, the dominant female, named Clover, hunts in the grass. She and a few more Anolis make up the large group known as the Chain Gang. We've already seen many of their new hatchlings. But the skink babies are out in full force as well. This one, although not technically a recently hatched baby, it's still a baby nonetheless. Like the baby Anolis, the young skinks also have an incredible sense of their new surroundings. It's no time before they can navigate through the obstacles of the property with the expertise of their parents, although their parents teach them nothing. Same for the Anolis. Yet the young Anolis are always alert to the presence of the skinks. This one dives for the safety of the grass. The female is unaware that there may be danger nearby. But not from that skink. It is much too small. Ziggy, the dominant male, is nowhere to be seen. Of course, the small skink is no threat to the larger adult Anolis. And the baby Anolis all know and recognize the danger and take appropriate action. They hide out of sight. Anolis seem to be able to recognize different animals and people. They can tell who's friend or foe. By instinct, they know that skinks are the enemy. Yet to this date, I have yet to actually witness a skink eating an Anolis. But I've seen them stalking the hatchlings and chasing them many times. Fortunately, the Anolis are smart, and they seem to be able to outwit the skinks. The fence serves as a territorial boundary, but it offers the Anolis no protection from the skinks. But the latter does. The Anolis cling to it as if it were a life preserver. for them, it really is. For now, the skeet seems to have no interest in the anoles. It simply wants to bask. Skinks may look short-legged and slow up next to the more agile anoles, but rest assured, these skinks are anything but slow. And just as suddenly as it appeared, it just as quickly disappears. It has upset one of the hatchlings. Another rests below on a blade of grass. Each of them are aware that there is a skink lurking nearby. They take cover, but soon their leader, Ziggy, the dominant male, steps up to the plate. For the moment, the little ones are safe, with Ziggy there to protect them. They can come out to play. Just keep in mind, this is Skink Paradise. It would be in this youngster's best interest to be very, very careful. See you next time.